Hi, I'm Kevin Van Cartier. I'm a small filmmaker from California, specializing in documentaries of very grandiose subjects. Recently, I was presented with a unique opportunity to film a subject with much promise. A small town rock band with a big league confidence that promises to bring them to stardom. On my way to Nashville not long ago, my equipment truck broke down just outside the sleepy little town of Falls Creek, Tennessee. The truck was to take overnight to get repaired, so my crew and I decided that we would stay on overnight. We went to the local American Legion Hall to check out the Saturday Night Square Dance, and it was there that we saw a band that is destined to change the meaning of the word party. The Stew, as they're known to their loyal fans, so impressed me that I canceled my plans in Nashville and stayed here in Falls Creek so that I could film the early years of this band before they become stars. What you are about to witness is the early years of Dead Dog Stew before they become legends.
Artistic ability, that's like Rain Man, right? show that
dude that could, like, could see stuff.
You mean it.
On it, man.
Right. Stay off the drugs, man. So, what I'm saying here is that if you trust me, you know, I can really do things for you. Now, we've got a little contract here, right? And, you know, there's just a little, you know, print on the front page. But if you guys could just sign this, and we'll be all set, right? Just sign there on the dotted line. You remember how to do that?
I can just make right?
An
X. Right.
Big X, right there. Right. Okay, Padres, this is going to be big. You know what I'm saying? You know my work. You know you can trust me, right? All right, these girls are going to flock to you. They're going to say, hey.
So, T, how did you guys get up here?
Well, we started off in Cocoa Beach, me and Rex, man.
That's where we're from, man.
Yeah.
Cocoa Beach.
We worked at the Ron John Surf Shop.
Yeah. A great place. T, he worked like from 12 to 8 o'clock in the
24
morning.
Hours,
in the AM.
24-hour surf shop, man. We decided to just get out of there, man, because, well, for one, they fired us, and for two,
we're
sick of living with our parents, man. So we came up here to Tennessee, man, started our own surf shop, man. So that's going real well, man. But not a lot of people buy stuff, but it's going real well, man.
It's going well, huh?
Yeah.
We discovered there's not a lot of surfers in Tennessee.
Yeah. But so now
Which
we're
I
up
can't
here,
understand,
man. We started our band up here, man.
Yeah,
we hooked
man.
Up with some good guys.
Yeah, now how did you hook up with these guys?
Well, we met him, man. We met Timmy from he was
We needed a wrench, man.
Yeah, well no yeah, well we went and needed a wrench and we found him in the hardware store, man. And he was playing the violin on his lunch break. We were like, hey, can you play guitar, man? Because we need a guitarist for our band. And he said, no. But we made it. We taught him how to play guitar, man. So.
And Timmy, talk about a crazy bastard, man.
Timmy's kind of a dork, man, but we like him anyway.
No, that's right. He's a little uptight sometimes.
He's all right.
I kind of balance things out with Timmy, you know.
Yeah, man.
How did you hook up with Dead Dog Stew?
Well, like I was getting this ride from this trucker guy. Up from Alabama, and I get off and the guy leaves me sitting there.
That's
the exit, man. And so these guys like drive by and throw a beer bottle at me, and like, you know, it hit me in the head, nice bruise. But since they hit me, they stopped, and it happened to be these guys, and they were all like hanging out and. That was just about it, you know. I got in the car and they gave me a ride and gave me a part-time job waxing surfboards.
And you became a member of the band.
Yeah. We sat around and talked about it and I told them I couldn't play any sort of instrument. But
we didn't care, man.
But these guys were like totally rad, just like completely hanging out, chilling, dude.
Yeah, man.
That was cool. I mean, man.
Well, it sounds like you have a pretty good opportunity with this video that Frank's going to be producing.
Yeah, we really like Frank. His name's like Shrimpton or something like that. He found us. We were playing in for some high school in a bowling alley. He really digged our stuff, which is completely understandable. But anyway, we're really excited about
it. Yeah, man, it's like we've got the talent, you know, for the band, and he just knows how to, you know, get us out there, you know.
Yeah. So you expect to go places with Frank?
Yeah, man, we're paying him like $8,000 and we mortgaged the surf shop, so we really dig his stuff. Expect to go far with
doing a video.
An old bottling company, you see all the cans and stuff. But nobody, it's condemned, I'm pretty sure. That right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty condemned. So that's why nobody bothers us out here.
We're going to fall through any minute.
Yeah,
that's curious.
Sweet, dude, I love that. This is our best set, dude. I mean, like, rocking.
Stu's biggest influences in music?
Well, I'd say my main influences are the Peace Corps, thrash band from Miami, and Bing Crosby.
For his singing ability?
Well,
he was a crooner. He really was.
Dude, total crooner.
Yeah, man.
Total crooner.
I really I got into back in the 70s, man. I was really into Mott the Hoople. These guys wailed, man.
Yeah.
But then later on, right now, man, I really, really dig this one-armed doom for this dude from Def Leppard, man.
God.
That guy's really intense, man. He's got like one arm, but he still plays the drums,
he's
man.
Drummer, man.
I mean,
God.
Man, there's just no beating him.
I think it's going to have to be greats like Rat or Crocus.
Yeah.
Crocus.
I mean, that album cover they've got, whoa.
You guys are far out.
Yeah. I guess mine are Beethoven. And, you know that.
So,
and that guitarist from Wang Chung. I like that a lot.
Are groupies a problem for you guys?
Yeah, I would say definitely so, man. You know, they all really want to get close to you, and they want to, you know, get your autograph, and they want to, you know, be near the band, you know. And it
can be a real problem, but, you know, you just sort of have to learn to deal with it. You know, you just have to accept that as part of the territory of being a rock star.
Yeah, man, this rock video, man, the graveyard is going to be killer for the video, man. This place is, it's so killer, man, because I like to hang out here all the time anyway, man. I mean, what better place to shoot the video than the graveyard?
I think it's going to be fun, John.
Yeah, man. Look, there's lots of dead people here. Dead dudes all over the place.
Oh, man. And they don't bother you, know what I mean?
Hey, man, how come y'all are so damn dead? Hey, man. Killer, man.
Hey, we can get a shot of me riding on one of those monuments.
Yeah, man. We'll, like, you hook up the car, these jumper cables, and the jumper cables, these dead dudes, and see if we can get them back to life. Come on, man.
Hey, man, I got a great idea, man. This is so killer, man. Holy shit. A song about death.
Death?
Yeah.
Man, that would be really cool.
Uncharted ground, dude.
All right, hey, everybody, look, Uncle Frank's here. Hey, what? Hi, Glory boys, how are you doing? Uncle Frank, yeah, good to see you. Oh, what do we have here? Hey, what's going on? Listen, work with me, people, here. Look, we need more lighting over here, all right? We need some lighting over here. Camera two over here. Look, come over here. And you, yeah, you, come here, water boy. Hey, I need a towel. What is this? I can't work with this. Stay off the drugs, people. People, Timmy, I need you on three. What is this? Where's the XR2? Huh? I need this. All right, look, we got no sheets. Huh, what do we have here? Yeah, you boys been drinking? That's what I thought. Look, Jesus Christ, give me a break. Yeah, and give me a Perrier too, okay, all right? Oh, Jesus Christ, look, the stew, right? That's what they call you, right? Well, they might as well call you the dew. Why don't you get up your arm? Get over here. I'm trying to work here. I'm an artist. Would you please work with me, huh?
I don't know about this death thing, man. It's just kind of...
Don't worry, dude. Everybody here's dead, man.
Yeah, man. We wouldn't be doing this if they were live, you know? I mean, in a live yard or something.
Yo, come here. All right, I want you standing over there. Over there. Get over there. All right, and now, hey, you, yeah, acid freak, come here. Look, I want you looking over here, look into the camera, and then turn around and run.
Frank.
Yeah, you, babe, yeah, what?
What is it, babe?
Just a question.
Yeah, I got time, work with me.
What kind of work have you done in the past with rock music?
What, you haven't heard the name Uncle Frank? You know, it's synonymous with popular hits, you know. Have you heard of, Ike T. Johnson? His hit, you know, Flamin' Fireball?
Sure.
The big video, you know, with the comets and you know, we had to go to a lot of, you know, difficulty to get out in space and do that kind of stuff. But, and then MTV calls me up, right? They says, you're Uncle Frank. I said, damn right I'm Uncle Frank, all right? What do you want me to do? They said, we want you to do something with Michael Jackson. I said, Michael Jackson is too small for me, all right? I said, I'm Uncle Frank. I've got a reputation here. And so, you know, they call me up. And then they said, you know, we got this budding young talent. They're called Dead Dog Stew. I said, Dead Dog Stew, what the hell does that sound like? That sounds like, you know, a bad, chuck wagon soup or something. You know, what are you saying to me? And then they said, Dead Dog Stew, you know, they're really good. They're up and coming. They're budding. And I said, okay, well, give me a try here. I see these guys, they're all on drugs, you know. Stay off the drugs. It burns the brain cells. You know, they don't have any left. But you know what I'm saying? So they call me up, and I said, hey, I get wiped with this stuff, you know. I'm a potential director, you know. That's I see potential and I go and I grab it, and you know, that's what I really like about me, among the other things, is that I'm out for the good, wholesome rock industry. So that's all. All right, look, see what we're gonna do here is we're gonna go for the strobe light effect. The strobe light is an incredible technique that I've been using on quite a few of my videos lately, and what it does is it really pronounces the mystique of the whole ambiance of the film, you know. And if you're looking at it and you say, hey, what's going on here? And then you put the strobe on, you say, hey, I got it. So, you know, it's all right there. So you understand, maybe, you know, you're making this movie, you might want to consider throwing a strobe light in there. That's always popular, you know, and the women, it drives them crazy. You know, they say, strobe light, Uncle Frank, you know, that must... He's doing the strobe light again. So they come, you know, and they're all crazy about me. Now come over here and let me show you something else. All right? Okay. Now, see, what we're going to be doing here is we're going to be hanging, you know, like, up in the trees. We're going to get my main cameraman. His name is Sean, right? He's from the block. You know, he's going to be up in the trees, right? And see, that's the kind of people we work with here, you know? Professionals. That's what we are. We're professionals. We're professionals. You know, Uncle Frank, the professional.
Yeah. The shark in a graveyard.
It's going to be really scary, man.
Yeah, that's what I like. It's scary.
And you're in the graveyard, you're not expecting to see a shark, man, because number one, it's on land.
Number two...
Well, you've heard about those land sharks.
Yeah. Number two, it's dead.
Oh, man.
A dead shark, man? What could be more terrifying? Dead dog stew.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That, in essence, is what we're all about, man.
It's like we're in this big bathtub, right, and the shark comes in and eats us all up. And then we're like dead dog stew. Only there's a shark. Yeah. But how would a shark ever get in a bathtub?
I don't know, man. Good.
That's the thing. Sharks.
Well, how do you think the shooting's going so far?
Well,
the video?
You know, we're having some good luck so far, but these dope heads are pretty hard to work with. I mean, they're pretty numbskulls, you know, thick in the head. But, you know, I think overall, because of my incredible artistic ability, I think we're doing an okay job here. You know, people in this business, you know, they're hard to work with. But, you know, when you've been in the business for, like, you know, 20 weeks like I have, you know, you got a rapport with these people. You know, they say, hey, who are we going to get to produce a video? They say, hey, Frank Byrne, let's call Uncle Frank. You know, so they look up, you know, they let their fingers through the walker and they call Uncle Frank. And I, you know, I work with these people, even though they got an IQ lower than my shoe size, you know what I'm saying? They're all on drugs and stuff. But, you know, we can do this stuff. It works for us. You know what I'm saying?
Man, this video is going to be great, man. We're going to hit the big time with this thing, man. We're going all the way to the top. Yeah.
Our dream.
Yeah. This is the best thing that ever happened to Dead Dog Stew, man.
This is where I envision us in the future, man. Tons of gorgeous
bays. Yeah, man.
Lots of free beer.
Beer, man. Beer.
Drugs,
yeah, man. Drugs.
Loud music.
Yeah, loud
and
music.
High-paying, glamorous careers for everybody, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, man.
Okay.
So here we are. This is the Ron John Surfshop.
Right here, man. Our humble abode.
Falls Creek, Tennessee. Yeah, it's like a combination between where we live and where we work, too.
Yeah.
We're not playing the band.
Okay, man. I'm going to have to ask you and your cameraman to put these helmets on, man. Because as you'll soon see,
the building's really...
It's kind of a wreck. In fact, it's condemned.
It's a very dangerous
and
place
to
live.
And we got to work out with the State Department, man. They'll let us live here if we agree to wear helmets at all.
Yeah.
It's kind of uncomfortable when you're sleeping and all, but, you know...
But they're pretty cool helmets.
It's a cool house, man. There's a lot of room for the
okay,
boys
man.
In here.
Come on inside and check it out, man.
You're going to like this place, man. This
is where
we live, man. Shipment of turf wax in.
Okay,
really
man.
Killer.
Okay, come on in, cameraman.
All right, this is our kitchen. This is where we make our food and all that stuff, man.
Yeah.
And this is, we've got to do some work on the ceiling in here.
You should have seen it before, though, man. It's looking pretty good.
We've worked on it a little bit.
There's
this is where we
funny.
This is our workshop, and that's the bed right there.
Here's where we're working on designing some new boards right here.
We're working on some new stuff.
Right here, these are our materials for new boards.
Yeah.
And back here,
this is what I want to show you, man. Hey, come on, man. Come on, this is what I want to show you right here, man.
Boards. These are our new prototype boards, which we've named. This is that one right there, or this one in the middle, is the Super XJS High Fly 2000.
Made out of...
Dioxified marbling,
which is basically denutrified recycled material.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this was probably like diapers or something.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
See, we go to the recycling shop and they do us big hunks of shit like this, man. They'll buy this
shit.
What we do is we get the blowtorch and torch that stuff down into one of these bad boys and you ride in the wave, man.
Yeah.
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 So
how good are your sales?
Sales? We don't have any sales, man. We don't sell those, man. Just boards and
wax,
man.
No. Selling. How many boards do you sell a month?
How many?
Yeah.
Well, we haven't sold any yet.
Yeah, man. Really? How long?
But we're not open a lot, though, man. Cause we're busy with the
we're
band.
Out
a
lot of
time. We really don't have time to come by here.
Yeah.
You know,
how long have you guys been open up here?
A couple years. 3 years.
Timmy, what's T doing over there?
He's seeking musical inspiration.
What, is that how he comes up with ideas for songs?
Oh, yeah, man. See, what he does is he'll sit there in the lotus position for minutes, hours, all night if he has to. Whatever it takes, you know.
Okay, so he comes out of this with a song all worked up.
No, never. What he ends up having to do is go home and watch TV until he gets an idea. That's where his songs come from.
Oh.
I was listening to your demo tape yesterday, trying to figure out some of the lyrics to the song. And I had particular difficulty with cheese.
Well, yeah, actually, that's funny because we had a little bit of trouble writing that, you know. It's about a girl who likes on her knees. And then we tried to, you know, come up with something to rhyme with that, man. We tried, you know, peas and, you know, keys. And
trees didn't work.
Yeah, man. Trees was bad. So then, you know, Ivan here, man, he just likes, he works around pizzas all day long making pizzas.
Gas.
And gas, you know, it pumps gas.
But the pizza is important.
Pizza, and so he was like, well, why not cheese, you know? So play it.
Yeah, play it, okay.
I know a girl, and she likes it on her knees. And when she says please, she says, I love your cheese. I think it really works really
Dude.
Well.
Cheese.
Yeah.
The whole thing of it is that the song, when you get down to it, it's all about urban alienation.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's the whole
youth
key
culture,
of the song.
How we're alienated.
If you understand that, you understand the song.
Yeah.
Cheese! 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 band.
Look, that guy.
Yeah, that kind of band. And look, they even write on our walls.
They're really into graffiti, dude.
That's our insignia, so.
Dead Dog Stew. Can you see that? Look. Dead Dog Stew.
That's us.
That's us.
The lighting arrangement for most gigs are you turn on the lights like that, and then you turn on this light down here, and then what's really cool is I stole this strobe light from my little brother, man.
Found it.
He didn't.
Yeah. You turned it to the right.
And here it is, man. See, like it makes these weird flashing lights. You can see that, man. Like move like this, and it makes it seem really weird. But so anyway, there's the strobe lights. And other than that, we don't have any lights, man.
I'm gonna show him my drums.
Oh yeah, man.
If that's cool with you,
dude, go ahead.
Okay. All right. First of all, you got all these drums, right? Some cymbals. But look at this stuff. Here's the really cool part. Come on down here, man. This is great stuff.
Here, man. Look, I got this like foam pillow stuff, man. And move this light out of the way. Double. Get like a bit, man.
Just like
down
this, man.
Here a lot, dude.
And if you want to be really cool, someone hits the bass drum and it like pounds your eardrums tremendously.
I do that when I'm playing bass sometimes. I lay down.
Yeah, man. Just, you get tired, you put your feet up here.
And you can play in here.
And you just rest for a while, man. And you don't even have to play if you don't want to. That's the beauty of it, right there, is you can rest.
So, are you guys looking forward to your gig next week at the Snake Pit Theater?
Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, totally rad. Totally.
There's going to be lots of people there, and we're going to be playing, too.
Dude, somebody's at the door. Come in.
Boys!
Uncle Frank!
Boys! It's Uncle Frank. I'm here, and what do I have here?
What's happening, Uncle
it's
Frank?
The video!
Oh, yeah!
Okay. Hey, okay.
Right on.
Hey, I love you guys.
Why, you're all
the
Freddy, man.
You're my guys, right?
Hey,
yeah.
Here, get the video.
You're my guys. Okay,
man.
All
mean, better than like that Def Leppard video I saw. It was so death. It was great, man. The graveyard scene and that dude like all wrapped up and just like, man, it couldn't have been any blacker. It was great, man. I just loved it. Loved it, man, dude. Yeah, man. It was totally worth the $10,000. Totally, yeah.
Well, I thought it was kind of scary. It was just a little death in the graveyard. Scary.
So you didn't like it?
Well, it was just so scary.
What's your guys' reaction to the shark attack video?
Generally, it was pretty killer because we were in the graveyard and everything. But there were no chicks, man. There were absolutely no chicks.
I hate it, man. We weren't partying.
Yeah.
That's what we do. That's who we are, man.
That's what we're best at, man, is partying.
Yeah, man.
Rock and roll,
I didn't
dude.
See any of that in there, man.
Yeah, man. But then it sucked because of that, man. There was absolutely no partying.
Yeah,
it's just a graveyard, dude.
It was pretty
no
good.
No chicks,
but it sucked.
Yeah,
it's exactly my point.
Yeah, man.
Wait, move again. Chicken cacciatore in a bottle of wine. Me and my baby are feeling just fine. Couldn't be better if we were the same sign. Chicken cacciatore in a bottle of wine. And then it goes, chicken on my lips and love on my brain. We take a few sips and it goes down the drain.
Yeah. Let's try that out.
Let's
right.
play it. Count.
Oh yeah, count. That's the hard part.
Okay, man.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Feelings on censorship in rock music?
Well, we got some cuss words in our songs and stuff, you know, but we really haven't had quite enough exposure to be censored, per se.
My old lady won't let us play in the house. I mean, that's a good example of how we're censored.
Yeah.
Definitely affected.
We're definitely censored there.
Yeah.
But we don't care, man. I don't like my mom anyway.
Hey, man, it's been like 6 weeks since we made that video. I haven't seen Jack, man. It hasn't been on TV.
Yeah, man. I've been watching MTV a lot lately, man. Pretty much nonstop, pretty much, you know. And whenever I fall asleep, like I'll videotape it so I don't miss
That's
anything.
That's a real smart idea.
Yeah, so I don't miss anything. But then I have to go back and watch the videotapes and I miss what's really on. So it might play.
Hey, man, I say we go see Uncle Frank to find out what the deal is, man.
Yeah, man, let's go racing.
We'll get to the bottom of this.
He's giving us the run around, and we're supposed to be stars by now.
Stars. Glamorous careers for everyone.
Go show this guy. Hey,
here it is. It's over here, man. Hey, dude, where's our video, man? We haven't seen Jack, man. We want our video.
Boy.
Hey, man, where is it?
Have a seat, guys.
Hey, we want
how are you doing? Bob, just calm down, y'all.
Yeah, right.
All right, just calm down.
We've been taping it.
Okay. Look, these things take time, all right? I got people working on this video, all right? Gloria's been busting her tail, all over it, but listen, I've got people at MTV, all right? My cousin Tony, he's working on it, you know. But these things, you know, there's a lot of technical details. Excuse me, look, am I Uncle Frank? Am I sitting here listening to this, all right? Look, would you mind looking behind you, please? All right.
Whoa.
Video, okay? Video's galore.
Wow, man.
Video Haven. Have I done that? Answer me, yes. Okay, thank you, boy. So, if you'll kindly just,
Okay, man, but what about replacement on the chart?
Yeah, man,
where are we on the chart?
All right.
Listen, okay, this is my area of expertise here. Okay, after video production, every film, every video must go through what we call here in the business as a dormancy phase, okay? Your video right now is in that phase where the potential is eminent for success, yet it's still kind of retaining its mystique in the category of maybe possibly big hit. What I'm trying to say.
How long are we gonna be in this dormancy state?
Yeah. Dormancy bay. All right. Well, that's really we get into a little gray area there. It really depends on the people at MTV. My cousin Tony, he may take a little longer. It really depends on the seasons, I think. I think what's best for you boys now is just to wait this out, okay? You've been beautiful. Thanks for coming by. I will be in touch, okay? That's right, okay? Listen, you're
big
great.
Stars,
you're a big star, okay?
Man.
That'll be great. All right? You're great.
A lot of babes.
I'll call you.
Babe,
I don't know, man. He said indefinitely, so that's pretty cool, man.
I guess that's good.
Yeah.
Indefinitely.
Indefinitely.
So we're on the right track.
Relying more on your video to bring you stardom.
Well, yes.
Yeah.
You know, it's a good video, though, man.
Definitely, man.
Definitely. Above average video, I'd have to say, man.
Dead Dog Stew going in the future?
Well, pretty much anywhere we need to go.
Yeah.
You know, if it's like the frat party or whatever, man.
Yeah.
You know, it looks like, you know, we've got some good gigs lined up. I think we got like a big tour coming up. We're going to be going to
man,
a couple of high schools and some fraternity houses and what else?
Bingo parlors, man.
Yeah, we got this bingo parlor gig lined up, and then there's this one guy who's getting his hair cut. He's growing out his hair for the World Guinness Book of World Records, and he's hiring us to play, man. So we think that's pretty cool, man.
That'll be a great gig.
Are you guys satisfied with being Dead Dog Stew?
Well, it really started off, you know, as just sort of a dream, you know, that we had, you know, a vision.
Big.
And just things started
piecing together, man, and when you put this much raw talent together, you're going to get, you know,
a bigger, something bigger dream, man.
A bigger dream. It's like the most bigger, amazing dream you could ever have, yeah. Except for that we're awake.
Yeah, man.
Totally.
I mean, it started.
We're not even asleep at all.
Yeah.
Not even tired.
No.
What do you guys think your contribution as Dead Dog Stew to humanity will be?
Well, man, as far as humanity goes, one thing that we try and strive for, like in our lyrics, is to bridge like the spiritual aura of humanity to like right. The beauty of nature, you know.
Whoa, man! Who's beef?
Oh man!
Jesus. You said you weren't going to describe our interview.
I can't believe you did that in our interview, dude.
Oh man!
Any other kind of stew.
No way.
We're the best kind of stew.